Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you guys for the new subscribers. Thank you guys for watching my videos. Thank you so much. This is going to be part three of ASP.NET Core to-do list. So I am gonna in the previous videos I did the whole adding and removing and everything. So what I the only thing I did is I forgot to change the team a little bit. So and then also I'm going to be using Alertify to let you know when it's adding, editing, and deleting. So let me show you guys. So this is the template. You can edit, delete, you can add a to-do, but this is I changed the CSS a little bit, so I turn it to that right there. So that's what I'm going to be working on it, and also I'm going to show you guys how to use Alertify to let you know when like a notification that will pop up. So that's what we're going to do. So let me go ahead and get the application here. So the application is this one here. So you can search it. You can edit. You can do pretty much everything. And if you want to get to this point here, you guys can actually go. You can actually go to my GitHub, or you can actually go to my channel and then watch the other videos. Let me get the channel. All right, so you guys can go to my channel here. This one here, it says create a to-do list using ASP.NET Core. This is part two. I got part. Just got to go to here, my videos, and look for the one. If you want to start from the beginning. Look for one that says part one. Let me find it. My goodness, can't even find it. I got so many. Got it all. Yeah, so part one, it should be. That's the ones for Alertify. Let me find. Right here. Say it's all the way over here. So if you guys want to do that, and this is gonna be part three. So let me show you guys the application after adding the CSS and also Alertify. So let me show you guys. All right, guys. So this is the application. This is the final. I did change a little bit on the CSS. So I added some stuff here so that way I can show you guys. So I added like coding challenge, HTML and CSS. I added coding, Angular, JavaScript, C Sharp. I'm gonna add up another one. It still works the same way. It's just add up. I'm gonna put down Martin Debs. I create that. See, this little nice notification pops up. This one here, if you want to edit, Martin's. Let me see, 12. See, it says item has been updated. So, and then you can delete it. See, item has been deleted. And you can still search. So if you want to put down C sharp, yep, see right there. Nice. Still works. So pretty cool. All right, but that's it. I'm just gonna show you guys. It's not gonna take that long. It's very simple, pretty fast. So you guys will see. All right, so let's go ahead and get in by adding this. So let's do that right now. Okay, so I got the application without the CSS. So the very first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to the GitHub. I'm gonna go ahead and share the address, the link on the bottom of the video. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna grab the CSS from here, and I am gonna copy it into the application. So I'm gonna go here and add it right now. It's gonna be very simple. Should not take too long. So let me go ahead and refresh this. Perfect. Few things I got to change over here. Let me go ahead and inspect this. Yeah, I got to figure out why this is why. Should be why. Let me go ahead and find out. So, okay, after you guys add up the CSS, you're gonna have to give it a class. So on this one here for the TR, I'm gonna give it a that class that I give it a class of title, which is just over here, this class right here. So you gotta give that class to your TH, the same thing over here. That's what I was, I almost forgot about that. Title. And here for this one, we're gonna give it a class of, it's gonna be called new to do. So that's coming right from the CSS that we added right here, this one here. So title and new to do. So let me see what else, make sure I've got everything. Okay, so now let's go back and the application should be different. Yeah, it did already change. Let me refresh it. Yep. Should be changed. Actually, let me go ahead and close it and refresh the page again. Make sure it's working. Yes, second. Let me go ahead and refresh it. Okay, cool. So it refreshed. Yeah, so here it is. I'm gonna go ahead and add up a new to do. Angular. Make sure it's working. Yeah, it's still working. Okay, let's add up CSS. Oh, that's for searching. Keep forgetting about that. So let's go ahead and add up CSS. Let's add a few of those. CSS, let's add up another one for C sharp. Okay, cool. So that's working. All right, perfect. So now if we delete it, it's not gonna work. So well, in order for that to work, we're gonna have to go to here on the bottom where it says JavaScript. We're gonna have to create some functions here. It's not gonna be that complicated. So let's go ahead and do that right now. It's getting actually, no, it's not gonna work. We have to install the library. So let's do that right now. So if you guys go to my GitHub. Okay, so what we're gonna need is we're gonna need Alertify. We're gonna have to grab the CDN. So we're gonna need the CSS, which is this one. I'm gonna go ahead and copy this one. And now I'm gonna go ahead and go to my share folder, and this is where it says layout here, and I'm going to go ahead and copy this one. So I am going to copy the link. Actually, hold on, let me see. Nope. Yeah, you got to type in link and go ahead and type in here the CDN. Okay, that's for the CSS, and now you're going to need the one for JavaScript. So you got to go here, back over here, and you're going to have to get this one. Let's go ahead and copy that one. And you're going to go ahead and type in script just like that. And then let's put source. And then you can copy the link right there. So besides that, you're going to need jQuery. I have jQuery. I have the links, the CDNs. So I'm going to go ahead and copy these two. Go ahead and copy these two right here. Actually, yeah, so these, you're gonna need these right here, the jQuery. So, because if not, it's not gonna work. Okay, cool, so we have that. So now we can actually go to this page here, okay? So over here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a function. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, so we're back over here into my index page. And here I am gonna create a function. And it's just like this function. And here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a variable. It's going to be called save. And this one is going to be, I'm going to use the temp data. And this one is going to be called save. Save this one. So I'm gonna do the first one. I'm gonna create a function. I'm gonna create an if statement. So it's gonna be if save, it's not equal blank. Like if it's not empty and the like, let's say the form is not empty and you filled it up, you want it to alertify success. And this one is going to be save. So I'm gonna copy this one. This one is for the save. This one is going to be for edit. Let's make it lowercase edit. And this one is going to be called edit. And this one you want to go ahead and display edit. Okay. So and then you're going to create one for delete. So this one's going to be called delete. And you want to do this one, you instead of being success, you want to do error. And this one is going to be delete. So sure, that's that. All right, let's go ahead and build the application again. Actually, I can just hit F. I'm just going to hit Control R. To refresh. Let's see if it works. Let me go ahead and add up a new one. I'm going to go ahead and add up coding. And now it didn't work. Let me find out why it didn't work. Shoot. Syntax. Where is that? Delete. Oh, I see why. This one's supposed to be delete, and this one's supposed to be edit. And all right, so that's that. And the delete. I'm sorry. I'm gonna call it del because it has to match this one. All right, so that's that. So it was supposed to match that. So I created a variable and I forgot to change these. So let me go ahead and do that real quick. Let me go ahead and refresh the page and let's test it again. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this one. Let me go ahead and put down to-do list. Let's see if it works. And no, it didn't work. Crap. Sorry. Let me figure out what happened. Okay, so all right, so it's not working still. So let's go to the controller. Let's make sure the controller matches this right here. So let's go to the controller. Let me go to the to-do controller. Well, let's look. Oh, here's my problem. Okay, so here's supposed to be save. That's for the edit. And go back to when you add up one. Here. This one's supposed to be saved. So in other words, it has to match the same pattern that you put over here. So. Oh, I put edit for edit. Okay, so let me go ahead and change that again. This is save. Let me go ahead and put down edit and make sure it's not capitalized, make sure it's lowercase. And for the delete, of course, delete. Hold on, all right. This one's supposed to be error. That's it. There's an error there. You got to make sure there's an error. This item does not exist. And this one here, you got to call it delete. All right, cool. So now we can build it again and see if it works. We'll test it again. All All right, so let's build up again. Let me go ahead and try the adding one. So let's do programming. Let me go ahead and add one. Oh yeah, cool, now it's working. The item has been added. All right. Okay, so let me go ahead and edit programming for live, forever, how about forever? Let's try forever, save, perfect. Okay, so it's been updated. Let me go ahead and delete it. And delete it. Yeah, this item has been deleted. Perfect. All right. Cool. So it worked. All right, guys. So that was it. I just wanted to give you a little video on it, how a little CSS and adding a little bit of Lertify, it can make a big difference on the application. So check it out. So I will share the GitHub on the bottom of the video so you guys can play with it. You guys can do more to it if you guys like. So stay tuned for more videos, guys. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more videos coming out. All right. Thank you, guys.